We are live, and let's go and take some risk. Joining a pool here. Let's hope we make it into it. Practice game, yeah. Excellent. I have played against at least two of those guys before. I think Sam Boy is the one I had played before. I think he, yeah, okay, he's a grandmaster. Fanti, of course, is a grandmaster. Tefra is a grandmaster. Wes Gibbons is a grandmaster. Damn, I'm going to get my ass kicked here, bud. That's going to be fun. So, yeah, this is a practice run for Kilpeed Open, round 6. We are playing on a map called Orbital Objectives. The setup is auto as usual. There's a fixed card bonus. The turn timer is 90 seconds. We have Fog of War active, so this might be an interesting one. Blizzards are off, portals are active and unstable. Alliances are on. We have balanced blitz, and if anyone drops their connection, we are going to have an expert level AI difficulty. Of course, not rank the game, and inactivity behavior if someone bots out, either voluntarily or involuntarily, is automated. So let's see how it goes. We have the coffee. And let's see how it goes. I really need to practice those Fog of War games, and more or less on all kinds of maps. So after this game is finished, I will probably stop the recording and then get maybe into the lobby, play Fog of War games on a map that I have never played before, so it's even more difficult. But this will be interesting. Of course, Fanti is a very strong player. I mean, he has over 30,000 FFA rank points. Tefra has 26,700. Wes Gibbons, 28,200. Samboy, 26,700. And me, a lowly intermediate on 7,500. So this is going to be a... will be interesting to see how we go. I really expect that I will be the first one to get kicked out. And no hard feelings. I mean, I am playing much more skillful players. So that's all part and parcel of playing stronger players. It inspires you to work on your game and become better. And it's the same as with chess. I tend to play better as a rule of thumb against stronger players because I have to really put my mind to it and make sure that I don't make any stupid mistakes. But it also can lead to a bit passive play. And in this one, since it's fixed cards, it might turn out to be quite an interesting proposition when it comes to playing good neighbor and stuff like that. It will be interesting. I am by far the lowest ranked of the five players already here, and General Lovejoy is a master. Yeah, okay. I don't have all those fancy emotes that the other guys have. So, let's ready up and let's rock and roll. This is going to be an interesting challenge here. So, I am in the fifth place. Okay. Is this a bonus? Let's take a look at the bonuses. Okay, I need those three if I want to take a space station. and so let's see how it goes. Just so basically, if I want to take a bonus, I think my best chance is to take it from here and go through those. That might be my best option. But I am in fifth place, so I have no idea how to go about this. At least not yet. I don't think this is, yeah, probably Jupiter, the big one. No, this is the Sun. I really doubt that anyone can take that. It's going to take a hell of a blast to get there. This might be Earth. So yeah, this is a pretty big map, so I'm gonna have to zoom out a bit just so everybody can see something. And then of course my camera is sitting there on the side, so let's see, what is Black going to try? I'm going to get out of the Sun area here. Since this is fixed cards, I think we need to get a bonus. And let's just see what Black wants to do here. So I will probably drop all of mine on here and take those two and sit on this portal. I will just let this one sit for the time being. I might get kicked off. Let's add one there just to make sure that we don't lose it immediately. Okay, got a perfect roll. Okay, so we have a bonus. Okay, he may not like it, but sorry, forgot to end my turn. And I wouldn't be surprised if someone breaks me here. And looking at the way green is set up there, he probably wants this, but I will get out on the next turn. So let's see again. Earth is 4 points. Okay, let's just keep everything. I'm not going to stay in green sway too long. I'm going to get out on the next turn if he doesn't hit my five. Okay. White and blue have taken their continents. And if he doesn't hit me, I might actually just take here and then fortify over there. Just missed if he signaled something to me, so okay, so who is he going to hit? Okay, he takes this one. asteroids are 3 points. Mercury is 4, Neptune is 2, Saturn is 3, Venus is 3, Mars is 3, upper Jupiter is plus 3 and lower Jupiter is plus 3, Earth is 4, Uranus is 2, and satellites and space station is plus 3, and the moons are 4, probably, yeah, moons of Earth and Jupiter combined. Okay, let's drop in one here. 2 there. Let's put the rest in there. Okay, we lost one. Let's go there. So, let's send him a little heart there. It's all yours. So Fanti is the blue player, and he is probably the strongest in the field. So I think the sun will be the spot where we will probably trade cards the most. And I think everybody except for white has something there. So yeah, green, black, magenta, red, and blue. So is he taking the green spot here? Yeah. Yeah, so he's taking the asteroid belt. So he has two bonuses on the start. That's a ballsy move by Fanti. Pretty ballsy. So let's see how everything goes. There is extremely likely that this video is going to be extremely choppy because I haven't rebooted my computer in 2 days. So I might have made a big mistake. But we'll see. The webcam might be very choppy. I'm not too worried about it. Okay, so what is pink going to do? Already has this one. So let's take a look at the settings. Unstable portals, and I still have this one, which is surprising because I had this one on the last turn. So I presume green will snap through here to grab the cards. And probably, yeah, he will probably fortify to the portal. Yeah, wouldn't be surprised. Okay, he wants to keep a little defense on his borders. Okay, so black, what are you going to do, mister? I am only holding 12%. And this is a 70%... domination game. So whoever manages to do the 70% run is going to win. And I think it's going to take a while before anybody can get there. I don't think it's going to be a very sensible thing to keep hitting black. So on the next turn, I would probably drop 3 in here, hit this pink, and then drag back. So, and yeah, we have an equal thing there. Let's drop in 2 there and here. I think I'll get out of this one. Okay. Do we have a trade? No. The luck of the cards follows me around, or the bad luck of the cards, more or less. So nobody is in a position to make a run just yet, but that might change really quickly. Okay, so now we have open portals. My portal is pretty strong here so far, and I think I'm gonna have to put all of my troops on it just to be safe. Looks like Saturn is going to be claimed by white. Okay, he has a 10 trade straight off the bat. So he's probably going to take at least a card there. Okay, and he breaks green. He goes for the green kill. Holy moly. So Samboy is out. And pink is already, yeah, General Lovejoy. So black, what is he going to do? Black is Wes Gibbons, a grandmaster. I think General Lovejoy is a master. Yeah. So I will take a card off pink here. I only have 27 cards, so it might be easy to take me out if somebody is set up to do it. But at the moment, I don't think anybody is. Blue, of course, is a major player. So I think I will drop everything in here. Yeah. Let's just leave this three there. I mean, it is connected to my other three behind. Okay, so blue takes a 10 turn. And the big question is, do I have a trade? No! Oh, why, oh, why, oh, why? My goodness. Goodness gracious. This is incredible. Bloody hell. I mean, I could have hit pink for the feed, but I don't really want to feed anybody. And it looks like blue is setting up to kill pink. At least he has a line on him, I think. And he might have a line on me as well. I have four cards and no set, which is extremely typical for my luck of the draw. Okay, white takes Saturn. So what is pink going to do? He has a lot of bonuses, so he is in a decent shape. is he going to do? Is he going to go after me now? Because he can probably feed me if that's what he wants. But I will take him down with me if he plays nasty. Okay, so he takes this bonus. And he backs off. Okay. So what is black going to do? Yeah, he has too many bonuses, so I think I'm going to break him here. Because his big stack is here. So the feeling that black might be on his way to break him here. Okay, he takes it there. Okie dokie. How do we best go about this? Has an attack line up here. Let's put in two there. I don't think I can survive very long. I mean, blue is so strong. But he doesn't have a trade. But he has a line on pretty much everything. But he will need to split if he wants to take me out. If we take a look at he got 13 troops on his turn, and I'm not going to take that quietly when he hits two of mine somewhere. Okay, so he is getting ready to kill something. So what is white going to do? He is also very strong. So who is he going to hit? Okay, he is just tickling Fanti there. Okay, so what is pink going to do? He doesn't have a trade. And his 15 is locked away on the portal, so he might have to hit some other portal, which basically they are all pretty well defended. So he might suicide into my 14 with the 9 and then take it with the 15. That is entirely possible. But I don't think he will do it. He probably hits just this 3 to take his bonus back. So what is black going to do? Is he going to hit him as well? He gets an 8 trade. I have a 10. But I am just so far behind in troop count, so I am in a pretty poor shape here. got an extra card there for Hubble. I think I'll just put everything on this one. Okay, let's see how it goes. We have three cards now. And we have a trade. So if I don't get wiped out now, I will probably survive another turn. So white and blue are the strongest. Pink is third in card strength, and then me and black are a bit behind, and I am obviously the lowest. So let's see, do I have a line on any kind of map run? 30 on 17 is not optimal. Okay, he's going to take that portal, or maybe not. No. And I have two portals now, which is handy, so I can basically drop troops on both. But I don't really fancy attacking this one here, because that really activates this 41 towards me. So what is black going to do? I might actually just put a 3 here or here, take this way and drag it back to my one of my portals. Okay, he takes there. I'm good with that, because he will probably, okay, he's moving towards the portal. For me, it's a self-defense kind of thing. So I'm sitting on 0 cards. Oh well, only one. One horse, and I wouldn't be surprised if blue has a trait on a 3 here. If he sets in, he is going to give us a bit of problem. I don't think I have enough cards to do a big run. But if I do, I would have to hit this, 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 come over here, but then I run into this 13, which is annoying. This 41 defends this one, so if I want to go on a run, I'm actually going to have to blast through the 7s, the pair of 7s here, and then continue down here. So is he going to defend his portal, or is he going to go into his big stack? Because that will be a massive, massive thing. So what is white going to do? This 8 stack here is not going to do too much, since all the portals are pretty well defended. Sorry about the choppiness of the webcam and of the video as a whole. So pink has 29% of the territories. But I don't think he is in a position to make a run for it. I could be wrong, because this is a game mode that I'm not very well versed in playing. I mean, he could hit this 3 with a 9, that's not going to get him anywhere. And he has no access through the portals due to the portals being so well defended. Is he going to take this bonus maybe? Yeah, he decides to do that eventually. And then just fortifies. Okay, black. What is he going to do? How is it best to do this? I think I'll put in two there. Maybe three. Okay, probably we see a 10 set from Fanti now, and he might actually, yeah, he sees a, has a 6 trait. Okay, and I'm always kind of scared to have Fanti behind me, because in the last round he took me out first because I got stranded with no set on 4. That was painful. I think something needs to be done about pink, though, even though pink is probably spreading out a bit thin, but he has 104 troops, and I have a feeling that not all of them are going to be happy about that. He has 2 cards, so he has no trade in this turn. White has a turn. That's Tefra, another grandmaster. He takes a 10 turn, or a 10 set rather. And the big question is he going to make a run for it? I have my doubts, but he has a pretty... Okay, he is going to go for it. No. He didn't go for it. So what is... He broke, of course, pink. And if pink takes this back, I might actually hit him here and here, break 2 of his bonuses. But that might not be such a good idea, because he has a 22 sitting here. And I'm not in a position to take him out. So, since I am basically the fish, I need the dudes on my next trade as my next card. What is black thinking? Okay. So he hits pink there and jumps to the stack. So he steals a bonus. I am not going to open this to me. I don't really have a choice because they are all open to me in one way or another. So maybe I just take this two here. I lost two troops on this. Yeah, which is annoying. Okay, so Fanti is going on a run. The big question is, does he have enough material for it? Okay, he takes this. He's going to take this. Is he hitting a 703? Yeah, okay. This is going to be interesting. Does he have enough material to get there? He needs to calculate a bit here. No, he doesn't get there. Doesn't have enough troops. Two-on-one, is he gonna get it? He got it and he strands on 67, 5v11. Good try, a very good try. So is white going to go for it? Because now he has a whole lot of small things that can just blast through anything. I think he went the wrong way there. Okay, yeah, he breaks everybody's alliances. But is white going to get there? He might use four. He has this 40 here. So I might survive part of this, mainly because I am too small to cause any trouble. Yeah, okay, he's getting it. Yeah. So Tefra was the winner, and it was fun. It was a fun game, but I'm gonna have to restart my computer right now because the streaming is way too choppy, and the recording. So, for any of you who want to continue to help me out. Working the YouTube algorithm and increase my support on YouTube. Please, if you like it, feel free to like the videos, subscribe to my channel, and on that note, thank you all, and don't let the risk take you out. Goodbye for now.